Finally, I present to you my 2018 Miss Universe pre-arrival favorites. This has taken me a really long time to make. I don't really know why. I think because I was waiting to hopefully find out more about the contestants, and I still don't know a lot about the contestants, so these are simply my favorites who have stuck out to me on social media. Girls who just seem to have that extra edge. These are the pre-arrival picks, and I just don't know much about them yet. I'm going to pick 16 girls. They're in no particular order. However, I will have like a top six kind of thing, like my top six favorites so far. And as many of you know, I don't know why I keep doing this. What does this mean? As many of you know, I competed at Miss Universe 2016, which was technically held in 2017 in the Philippines. This year, it is in Thailand. I'm literally dressed the opposite of what you would wear in Thailand. I totally would have been going to the pageant this year, except for the fact that I'm pregnant and I'd be like 32 weeks pregnant in Thailand, and that just did not seem like a very good idea. I'm not gonna be there, but I will be watching from the comforts of home here in Canada. I'm really excited to see what kind of show Thailand puts on. I know it's going to be amazing. It was super amazing in the Philippines. We had such a wonderful experience. The Philippines was an amazing host country. I really hope they have it there again one day soon. I was at the pageant last year. I was at Miss Universe last year when it was in Vegas, and I really felt bad for the girls because it just wasn't the same experience that we got in the Philippines. The things that we got to do, the people we got to meet, the things we got to see, and just the vibe of the country. And I know Thailand will be similar because they love pageants, but in Vegas it just wasn't as exciting, I don't think, for the girls. Miss Universe last year was a year ago yesterday. South Africa! November 26th. I got married on November 26th in Vegas.
We just got married in Vegas!
Married in the mid-morning at the Bellagio. And then we all had this beautiful brunch. And then, so Brennan, my husband, and I, and our moms went to Miss Universe right after brunch, after we got married. It was super fun. Enough of that. On to my picks for Miss Universe 2018. First on my list, I have Australia. She's very natural, very Victoria's Secret. She's really fresh looking. I think she's 24 years old. I think she does something. She has her master's in publishing. Other than that, I don't know much about her, but I really love her look, and I think she has the vibe of what Miss Universe is more going for, that natural, less glam look that maybe they would have gone for in the past. I'm really liking Australia. Next, I have Costa Rica. All I really have about Costa Rica is that she needs to work on her walk. yeah, I need to make some more notes on her, I guess. Now, kind of opposite to Costa Rica is Curacao. Her walk is incredible. I saw a couple of videos of her walk and it's amazing. It is a killer walk. So I'm excited to see her in prelims, excited to see what she brings to the table, and I think she'll be one that surprises people. Next, I have Spain, and Spain has caused a lot of controversy, and I think that she will make it because she's beautiful and because Thailand is a big country that supports transgender, transsexual people. I really think they're gonna push to have Spain in their top. Of course, it's ultimately up to the judges and to the Miss Universe organization who makes it into the semifinals, but from what I've seen from Spain, she deserves to be there just beyond the fact that she's the first transgender woman actually competing at Miss Universe. I have Thailand next. For me, whoever's the host country basically automatically gets a spot. That's just the way it is. But also, I think that her walk is strong. She seems to have a really good personality. Next, this could be a total given or maybe not, but that's Venezuela. I think she will make it. I've heard she's a law student. I don't know if that's true, but she has a strong walk. Venezuela always brings it, and so she probably will make it, but you never know. Venezuela did not make it our year, and a lot of people were totally shocked. You know, there was actually a lot of criticism around that I stole Venezuela's spot, but what people don't see is all the behind the scenes. They don't see the weeks leading up to the final night. They don't see the weeks leading up to the preliminaries. They don't see how the girls are behind the scenes and how the girls treat other girls, how the girls treat volunteers and those who work for the Miss Universe organization. And that plays a huge role in who makes it and who doesn't. So sometimes when a girl doesn't make it and everyone's super shocked, you can imagine what it might be like behind the scenes. I'll leave it at that. Next, we have Vietnam. I think she's gonna make it. She has a great walk. I love her hair. She really stands out. Right when I saw her, her hair reminded me of Miss Jamaica from a few years ago, from the year Columbia won, 2014, I think it was. 2014 or 2015? 14, yes. Next, we have India. I think India seems great. She has a great walk, she's a great speaker, she's beautiful. I think she has an interesting story about a change in lifestyle, that she is now really active, and she before lived a sedentary lifestyle and wasn't active, wasn't healthy, and now a healthier person. I don't totally know. These are the things that I'll find out with time here once the girls actually arrive and we start hearing interviews and stuff like that. She seems like a great contender. Now I have Canada. Da-na-na-na. Canada had not placed, as you guys know, at Miss Universe for like 10 years, because Natalie Glebova won in 2005, Alice Pinikin placed in the top 10 in 2006, and then Canada did not place for 10 years until I placed in the top 9 in 2016, technically 2017, the year that E-Reese won, and then last year Lauren Howe placed in the top 10. So Canada has maintained placing for 2 years in a row, and I'm hoping we'll be able to place for 3 years in a row with Marta. She is very model-esque. She's tall, she's beautiful, obviously, and so I think she'll make it. Number 10 on my list here is Ecuador. She seems to have a great personality, beautiful, beautiful walk, and she kind of, I don't know, she reminds me of a certain model or something. And now here is my top six. My six favorites so far who really stand out to me and who I think I could see as being the next Miss Universe after South Africa. Demi Lee. Did you see Ted? First in my top six favorites here is South Africa. I think she is gorgeous. She has something to do with Does she have something to do with the medical field or something? I don't know, I've seen videos of her like in hospitals and stuff, so I don't know if she's just volunteering or if maybe she's in medicine or something. Is she? Yeah, she's a medical student. Personality, a girl's story, what she brings to the table besides her looks is really important to Miss Universe now. It's more than just about being good on runway and being beautiful and being photogenic. It's about having the whole package and being an inspiration to women and really pushing boundaries. This is kind of a given. I've seen her in the top of everyone's favorites, and that's USA. Sarah Rose is a very relatable person. She's bubbly. You want to listen to what she has to say. You want to watch her. You just feel attracted to her. You see her. I feel like if you were in a room with her, she'd be like the magnet. You'd be magnetized to her. And so she's in my top favorites, and I mean, I'm confident she'll place at all. Never mind be in that top five, top six, or whatever they decide to do this year. Now I have who maybe a lot of people don't have. I don't know. Do a lot of people have her? I'm not sure. But I have Peru. I really like Peru. I think she is so fresh and bubbly and cute. And any of the videos I've seen of her, I really think to myself, oh my god, she's one of my favorites. Next, Puerto Rico. She is, I think, just like an angel. She is so beautiful. She looks so nice. I don't know if she is nice, but she looks really nice. She looks like someone that you just want to talk to. I just really like her so far. And next, this is maybe a given, I have Colombia. And I know so many people talk about Colombia, and there's actually been a recent controversy with Colombia, because apparently when she was asked about her thoughts on Spain competing, the first transgender woman to compete at Miss Universe, she said something along the lines of that the only people who should compete are women born as women or something. And she was asked her opinion and she gave her opinion. So I don't necessarily agree with her. Anyway, overall, I think she's a really strong contender. I think she'll do very well. What I find funny though about people who will hate on her for giving her opinion and for saying that, you know, transgender women should be allowed to compete at Miss Universe, those same people who say, oh, like, you know, times are changing, we need more acceptance, blah blah blah, some of those same people are the ones who get mad at the Miss Universe organization for changing and for being more about the women, the substance of the women, less about the physical beauty and being good at runway and all that kind of stuff. I feel like some of these people are so, they don't even know what they want. They want Miss Universe to change because they want it to be more inclusive, but they don't want Miss Universe to change because they want it to be like the glam 2003 to 2005 era or whatever. Just like when I competed, I was too big for what people thought should be on the Miss Universe stage, but yet those same people who didn't accept my body are saying, yes, transgender women should compete because times are changing. It doesn't even make any sense. So for me, Miss Universe is becoming more accepting of different bodies, of those who identify differently, than I think it's for the best. I don't know why we would fight against that or push against that. I think inclusivity is amazing. I'm just gonna leave it at that. And last but not least, I have my personal favorite. She has been my favorite since she competed at Miss World because I wanted her to win Miss World, and that is Philippines, Catriona Gray. I love this girl. I know so many people in the pageant world love this girl. She is so well spoken. She is nice. She is beautiful. She, to me, is the person to beat, the one to beat at Miss Universe 2018. I think she's the strongest contender overall that I've seen, that I know about. I have followed her for a while, so I feel like I know a lot about her. And she for sure is my number one at this point. You never know. I don't know much about all these girls. So that is it. That is my top 16 favorites so far, my pre-arrival picks. There will be more to come because I'm sure this will change next week once the girls start arriving, and of course will change once the girls are actually there competing after prelims and all that stuff. If you don't agree with me, that's totally fine. We can all have different opinions. Just ask that you don't write negative things about these girls on the comment feed, because it's just bashing other people gets us nowhere. You can support your country, but don't bully the other girls because it's just not cool. Until next time, guys.